In today's video, we're talking more on WWE Battlegrounds, as we now have confirmation on some of the game's features, plus Visual Concepts' new executive producer, Patrick Gilmore, has revealed his initial plans for the community. Let's get into that and more up next. So let's start out with the latest on WWE Battlegrounds, as the ESRB website now includes a listing for the game, and it actually confirms a lot of new information. First up, we have confirmation of the systems that the game is set to release on, with the game coming to Windows PC, PlayStation 4, Nintendo Switch, Xbox One, and Google Stadia. Not only does this mean the return of WWE games to Nintendo Switch following the disastrous WWE 2K18, but this is also the first WWE game set to release on Google's new Stadia platform. Alongside the reveal of the consoles, the written summary also provides a lot of new information, as the summary reads, "This is an arcade-style fighting game in which players engage in wrestling matches using custom characters and WWE superstars. Characters punch, kick, and throw each other during matches. Players can also attack opponents by using chairs, poles, alligators, exploding barrels, and falling cars. Wrestlers react to damage by crying out in pain and/or writhing on the floor. Matches are depicted in a somewhat exaggerated cartoon style, highlighted by impact sounds, slow motion effects, and occasional explosions. In one sequence, wrestlers climb and are shocked by an electrified cage while grabbing bags of cash. Some female wrestlers wear outfits that expose moderate amounts of cleavage and/or buttocks, whilst characters can perform taunt actions that are somewhat suggestive, including a hula-style circular dance." So there's quite a lot that we can take away from this, as the note of custom characters appears to confirm the presence of a creation suite and the ability to create custom characters, which is great news for creators, plus it also gives us an idea of the kind of over-the-top antics that we'll see, as alongside the ability to throw your opponent to the alligators, we'll also be able to use exploding barrels and falling cars, as the game is set to feature a lot of different interactive elements. Also mentioned, we see no various special effects like the ones seen in the trailer, therefore this slow motion effect might actually be part of the gameplay itself, rather than an effect that was added for the trailer. As for match types, the sound of an electrified cage match definitely piqued my interest, as it sounds as though the match types themselves are going to be exaggerated to match the gameplay, therefore it's going to be interesting to see what kind of new matches and game modes the developers dream up that wouldn't usually be possible. Also noted on the rating site was the inclusion of in-game purchases, which instantly triggers the worry of the game being filled with microtransactions, which is something that was a big issue with NBA Playgrounds, as a lot of the content in that game relied on the use of microtransactions to unlock them, and I would imagine that that is something we'll see in this game to an extent. However, in regards to the notice itself, this is a standard notice that applies to all games that offer up DLC. So that's the latest that we have on WWE Battlegrounds, but switching over to the WWE 2K side, Visual Concepts' new executive producer Patrick Gilmore is taking to Twitter to share his excitement at joining the franchise. Patrick wrote, "Thrilled and humbled to join the WWE 2K franchise, amazing legacy to uphold and paths forward to forge." As for what that path forward holds, Patrick also revealed that he's been reading the WWE Games subreddit and 2K's official forums to get an idea of what fans want to see, plus he also revealed that he has plans to launch a new formal feedback project in the coming weeks, which he says could start as soon as next week. Reading through Patrick's tweets, it's great to see him getting involved with the community and responding to people directly in the way like Corey Ledesma used to, as this kind of interaction is something that we haven't seen since the days of THQ, and it would be nice to see that continue. Anyway guys, that's the latest on both Battlegrounds and WWE 2K. There's still no word on 2K20 and whether we'll see any future updates there though, but once I do find out anything in regards to that, then I will be sure to share it. Until then though, let me know what you think of today's news in the comments. Have yourself an awesome day, and I'll catch you later.